In this lesson, you will learn how to add a hole in a solid at any angle. We will use a reference plane for this, and you will learn another way to create a reference plane. Open FreeCAD and create a new project in Part Design Workbench. Create a new sketch and select XY plane as the sketch plane, and select Create Rectangle and Draw a rectangle. Now add the dimensions of the rectangle, select Constrain Horizontal Distance, select this line and enter 100 millimeters. And now select Constrain Vertical Distance, select this line and enter 50 millimeters. Click Close to exit the sketch and select Path Operation and enter 30 millimeters as length. And click OK. And now I will show you how to create holes at any angle, and for this you will need a reference plane. But to create a reference plane, we will need auxiliary geometry that will determine the angle at which we will make the holes. First, we will create holes that will go through this edge of the model, and we will create auxiliary geometry on this face. Select this face and select Create Sketch. Select Create External Geometry and select this edge. And now select Create Line and draw a line so that the beginning of the line coincides with this point. OK. And now select Constrain Angle and select this line and this line. And enter 45 degrees. OK. This will be the angle that will determine the location of the reference plane, and based on this angle, it will be possible to determine the angle at which the holes will be created. Click Close to exit the sketch, and now we will create a reference plane. Left click outside the geometry to deselect all geometries. And with Ctrl key pressed, select this point, and this point. It is important to select three points because we will create a plane based on three points. Now select Create Datum Plane and click OK. And the plane has been created, and now we will create a sketch on this plane. Select this plane and select Create Sketch. You can slightly rotate the view. And we need view from this side. OK. Now select Create External Geometry and select this line. This will be a reference line to the model, which will help us to determine the appropriate position of the holes. Now select Create Circle and draw two circles so that the centers of the circles lie on this line. OK, select Constrain Diameter, select Circle and enter 8 millimeters. OK. Right click to cancel this command and select this circle and select Constrain Equal. Now draw the line. Right click to cancel this command and select this point and this line. And select Constrain Symmetrical and select this point and this line. And select Constrain Symmetrical. Now select this line and select Toggle Construction Geometry to change the line to a construction line. And now select this point and select Constrain Horizontal Distance and enter 25 millimeters. OK. And click Close to exit the sketch. Then select Pocket Operation and select Through All as Type. And select Reversed option. and click OK. And this way we created holes at an angle. And now by changing the angle of inclination of the plane, we can change the angle at which the holes will be made. And to do this, go to edit this sketch and change the angle value. Enter, for example, 60 degrees, OK, and click close to exit the sketch, and the inclination of the holes has also changed. To turn off the visibility of the reference sketch and the reference plane, select the sketch in the feature tree and press spacebar, and do the same with the plane. We can create holes at an angle anywhere on the model, and let's assume that I would like the centers of the holes to be 50 millimeters from this edge. And to do this, simply create an appropriate auxiliary sketch, select this face and select create sketch. First select create external geometry and select this line, and select create line and draw the line. And it is important that the beginning of the line lies on this reference line and the end of this line lies on x-axis. Okay, right click to cancel this command and select this point and this point and select constrain horizontal distance and enter here 50 millimeters. Okay, and click close to exit the sketch. Now we need another sketch, this time select this face and select create sketch. Press the mouse wheel and rotate the model slightly and select create external geometry and select this line to have a reference geometry to the previous geometry and to link this sketch to the previous sketch. Select create line and draw a line so that the beginning of the line coincides with this point. Okay. Right click to cancel this command and let's change the view and select create external geometry and select this line to have secondary geometry to determine the angle dimension. Select constrain angle and select this line and enter here 45 degrees. Click close to exit the sketch. And in this case, as before, select three points, select this point, and this point. Selecting points is not very convenient, but maybe it will be improved soon. If you want, you can turn off the visibility of the model for a while. Just select the last operation in feature tree and press spacebar. Okay, I need to select these points again. Okay, and now select create a datum plane and click OK to confirm. Okay, let's turn on the visibility of the model. And okay, the reference plane has been created. Now select this plane and select create sketch. Sometimes it may happen that when you make a sketch on the reference plane, it opens in a strange orientation, then you can simply rotate the view. There is no native option to set the view normal to the sketch plane, but you can get used to it. Now select create external geometry and select this line. Okay, right click to cancel this command and as before draw two circles, dimension them and add an axis of symmetry and place the circles symmetrically about the line of symmetry. Okay, click close to exit the sketch. I need to change this line to construction line. Let's edit this sketch and select this line and select toggle construction geometry and close. Okay, and now select pocket feature and for type select through all and check the symmetric to plane option to make the hole on both sides of the plane and click OK. And in this case we have a hole whose centers are at a specific distance from this edge and the holes are at a specific angle. In this case we can also change the angle at which the holes will be made. All we need to do is edit this sketch and change the angle value. For example 60 degrees and click close. Okay, and let's edit again. For example 30 degree. Okay, and close. And this was just an example of using a reference plane, but you can create much more complex designs using datum planes. That's all for today. Thanks for watching and please subscribe to this channel. This will help a lot in the growth of this channel.